Dr. Kirk, thank you very much. Thank you very much. It is a real pleasure to be here today to participate in the launch of the Southern African Trade Hub. It's a mouthful, but it's easier. It rolls off the tongue more easily than the previous global competitiveness hub. So I think that's a positive change and positive start right there. As you know, USAID established the trade hub back in 2002. So today is not just a launch, it is a renewal of the U.S. government of a U.S. government project that already has a long track record of success. I strongly believe that increased trade is key to achieving greater economic growth and poverty reduction. It is particularly important to address the challenge of food security in many countries. I am confident that this expanded engagement represented by the trade hub will have a deep, long-lasting, and very positive effect. I think it's fair to say that the new trade hub will be building on a very solid foundation, a foundation that has been laid down over the last 8 years through the excellent work of previous teams. The trade hub's key purpose is to address the challenges of economic growth and poverty reduction faced throughout the SADC region. This trade hub's focus will be on increasing international competitiveness, regional trade, and food security in the SADC region as the new team takes the program to even a higher level of effectiveness. This five-year, $80 million project is to be implemented by ACOM International Development under the able leadership of Dr. Robert Kirk, who brings over 25 years of experience in regional trade policy work to this new assignment. So we very much welcome you, Dr. Kirk, to Haberoni. The regional and international applause are appropriate at this point. The regional and international experts on his trade hub team will deliver targeted technical assistance to governments, the private sector, and civil society organizations throughout the SADC region. The aim is to help stakeholders strengthen regional and global trade linkages and support export-oriented business development. We are, of course, delighted that Haberoni remains the trade hub's home base. It is here primarily because Haberoni is also the home of SADC's headquarters. So I think it is appropriate, as we launch the new trade hub, to say a special word of congratulations to His Excellency Dr. Salamao, as he will be formally opening the new SADC headquarters building on Saturday. And he has, the time constraint is, he has a plethora of heads of state and foreign ministers arriving, so congratulations to you, Dr. Salamao. I hope you will be able to tell all of the visiting heads of state what a fine job that the Trade Hub has been doing in supporting SADC's efforts to increase trade and development and integration in the region. In recent years, the Trade Hub has supported implementation of the SADC Free Trade Agreement. It has assisted in modernizing customs procedures and improving the flow of goods along transport corridors. It has helped countries to develop bond markets and remove regulatory barriers to greater investment in the energy sector. I am sure even greater achievements lie ahead. I'd like to say that SADC's 15 members represent a vibrant and growing market of 240 million people with a collective GDP that is rapidly approaching the $1 trillion mark. Think about that. That is one of the largest markets in the world, and yet it's a market that is currently not as united as it should be. I think it is the work and the vision of SADC that will to bring this market into one. In the United States, when we were just getting started, we were 13 colonies. The flag of the one of the early flags of the United States was a snake divided into 13 pieces, and the motto was "In unity, there is strength." And I think that applies today, especially in economic terms. In unity, there is strength, and in SADC unity, there is, I think, a wonderful, bright future ahead. So it is SADC's own vision of establishing a common market with common regulatory institutions that is the real key to unlocking the tremendous potential of this important market. And I think it is the trade hub that will help to make that vision a reality. So I'm very proud today to be here to officially launch and recognize the opening of the new trade hub. Thank you.